see these films then on screen, obviously, because so much of it's really going to be computer generated and stuff. Does it feel amazing just to be like transported into that world?
Yeah, I mean, it feels good. Yeah, definitely. There's an element of anticipating it a bit, because obviously, you know, as an actor, you have only a limited element of control, i.e. what you're doing, and then you have to kind of leave it and see what happens. So you're watching it, hoping that, you know, it'll be good. but with this, it was really, really exciting, because they had done exactly that. They'd taken the world and they broadened it, and they'd, you know, pushed it a bit further. And, you know, the lessons that you learned from the first movie, and also you don't have to have that exploratory thing of introducing characters and introducing the world. So you can kind of really embrace the fact that it's a big action film and a spectacle movie.
And how has life changed for you since the first one? And have you got any great fan stories?
I get
more. You can get crazy here if you want.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Well, it's Radio 1. I get more free jeans. No, I'm kidding. I don't get free jeans, actually. How's my life changed? No, I mean, not massively. I live in London. I have my same friends. My family are here.
Do you get recognised much? Do people come up to you?
Yeah, you do get recognised, yes. But mostly it's fine. But I guess you don't... You have to avoid doing certain things, you know. I wouldn't probably, you know, walk if there was a big bunch of teenagers coming out of school. I think it wouldn't be wise to walk straight past them. But yeah, no, mainly it's okay. So, yeah. I'm the same dude, maybe.
Are you?
Hiya, Theo. Nice to meet you. Cassam from Hey You Guys.
Hey, man. How you doing?
How you doing, man? I'm very well, thank you. Now, massive film, massive sequel to the first one. Is it something you were expecting when you made the first one, that it was going to end up being this big?
In terms of the film itself, we're hoping, yeah. I mean, as I was saying, you kind of really want to, if you're going to come back for a second one, you need to really take risks, essentially, and push things a bit further in all directions. The good thing about this for me is that the character, you get to explore a little deeper. I mean, in the first one, he's a bit of a slow burn, and then you finally, you know, understand what he's motivated by. But in the second movie, there's an ability to explore him further, you know.
Sure, and you work quite closely with Naomi Watts, who joins the cast in this film. Can you tell us a bit about working with her?
Yeah, she insisted on calling me Mummy. And I was like, shouldn't I call you Mummy? But it was a kind of, you know, whatever she wants, right? She's been doing it for a long time now. She was great. I was really excited for her to come on board, really. I like the idea of not only, you know, her as an actress, but what she'll bring to the character. She has this natural kind of almost gentleness, an etherealness to her, which plays nicely against the character, which is someone who's kind of, you know, almost a tyrant.
Sure. And finally, last question, just what can we expect from the final two films that are coming out?
You know, more tighter shirts. No, I'm kidding. What can I expect? I don't know 100% because the scripts aren't finished. So we're you know, slightly in the dark as well. But the idea kind of goes outside the walls. Again, I think with every movie, we're trying to push it a little bit more, make it bigger. There's this idea of genetic superiority and what that means. So that kind of changes its moral dimension.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're watching Hey You Guys.
Hey You Guys, huh?
Hey You Guys.
Is that from the Goonies?
It is indeed, yes.
Nice. Hey!